Hello dear friends, welcome back. The basic motive behind this video is to make the people preparing for the interview aware of the interview puzzles that are mostly asked in Infosys. These puzzles also helps for other company interviews and also for data analyst and government jobs. These interview puzzles will help you brush up your skills and will make you more confident while giving the interview. Before getting into the details, do subscribe to the channel and make sure that the notifications are on so that you do not miss any of our videos. There are two candles of equal length and of different thickness. The thicker one lasts of 6 hours, the thinner 2 hours lesser than the thicker one. Ramesh lights the two candles at the same time. When he went to bed, he saw the thicker one is twice the length of the thinner one. How long ago did Ramesh light the two candles? It is given that thicker one lasts 6 hours, so after each hour, 1 by 6 of the candle is melted. Thinner one lasts 2 hours lesser than thicker one, that is, it lasts 4 hours. So after each hour, 1 by 4th of the candle is melted. Logically, after 1 hour, remaining portion of the thicker candle is 5 by 6 and remaining portion of thinner candle is 3 by 4. After 2 hours, remaining portion of the thicker candle is 4 by 6 and remaining portion of thinner candle is 2 by 4. And after 3 hours, remaining portion of thicker candle is 3 by 6 and remaining portion of thinner candle is 1 by 4. Here we can notice that after 3 hours, the remaining portion of the thicker candle is 3 by 6, which is 0.5 or half. Remaining portion of thinner candle is 1 by 4, which is 0.25 or quarter, which is basically the thicker one is twice the length of the thinner one. Therefore, the answer is 3 hours. There are 5 persons who have won top 5 places in an event in Olympics. One of them asks all the 5 regarding their positions. They reply as, A replies, I am not the last. B replies, C is in 3rd place. C replies, E is behind A. D replies, B is in 1st place. And E replies, D is not the first. The persons who have won gold and silver have lied. So with this condition, find the positions in order. Just ignore the last statement for some time. That is, the persons who have won gold and silver have lied. So as per the statements, the positions are B, D, C, A, E. Let's check all the statement satisfies the condition. In this arrangement, A is not the last and C is in 3rd place. E is behind A and B is in 1st place and D is not the first. So now applying the condition, gold and silver owners lied. Accordingly, B lied, which means that C cannot be in 3rd place. So rearranging again will result in B, C, A, E, D. Now gold and silver owner, that is B, C, lied. Accordingly, E cannot be placed behind A. Hence, the new sequence will be B, C, E, A, D. So now again, B, C lying and it becomes a loop here. So the correct answer is B, C, E, A, D. This will satisfy all conditions. A car has 4 tires and 1 spare tire. Each tire can travel a maximum distance of 20,000 kilometers before wearing off. What is the maximum distance the car can travel? You are allowed to change tires using the spare tire unlimited number of times. Note that all tires are used up to their full strength. Logic to this puzzle is, divide the lifetime of spare tire into 4 equal parts, that is 5000, and swap it at each completion of 5000 km distance. Let us consider 4 tires be A, B, C and D and spare tire be S. At 5000 km, replace tire A with tire S. At 10,000 km, put tire A back to its original position and replace tire B with tire S. At 15,000 km, put tire B back to its original position and replace tire C with tire S. At 20,000 km, put tire C back to its original position and replace tire D with tire S and travel for another 5,000 km. Hence, 25,000 km is the maximum distance the car can travel. A horse rider went a mile in 2 minutes with the wind and returned in 3 minutes against the wind. How fast could he ride a mile if there was no wind? Most of us will proceed like that if a rider goes a mile in 2 minutes with the wind and returns against the wind in 3 minutes, the 2 and 3 equal 5 should give a correct average, so that the time taken should be 2.5 minutes. We find this answer to be incorrect because the wind has helped him for only 2 minutes while it has worked adversely for 3 minutes. If he could ride a mile in 2 minutes with the wind, it is clear that he could go a 1.5 mile in 3 minutes and 1 mile in 3 minutes against the wind. Therefore, 2.5 miles in 6 minutes gives his actual speed, because the wind helped him just as much as it has retarded him. So his actual speed for a single mile without any wind would be 2.5 divided by 6, which is equal to 5 divided by 12 miles per second. The owner of a banana plantation has a camel. He wants to transport his 3000 bananas to the market, which is located after the desert. The distance between his banana plantation and the market is about 1000 km. So he decided to take his camel to carry the bananas. The camel can carry at the maximum of 1000 bananas at a time, and it eats one banana for every kilometer it travels. What is the most bananas you can bring over to your destination? First of all, the brute force approach does not work. If the camel starts by picking up the 1000 bananas and try to reach point B, then camel will eat up all the 1000 bananas on the way and there will be no bananas left for him to return to point A. So we have to take an approach that the camel drops the banana in between and then returns to point A to pick up bananas again. So there are 3000 bananas and the camel can only carry 1000 bananas. He will have to make 3 trips to carry them all to any point in between. When bananas are reduced to 2000, then the camel can shift them to another point in 2 trips, and when the number of bananas left are less than or equal to 1000, then he should not return and only move forward. So in the first part, P1, to shift the bananas by 1 kilometer, the camel will have to move forward with 1000 bananas and camel will eat up 1 banana in the way forward. Leave 998 banana after 1 kilometer and return with 1 banana. So camel will eat up 1 banana in the way back. P2 pick up the next 1,000 bananas and move forward. Camel will eat up one banana in the way forward, leave 998 banana after 1 kilometer and return with one banana. And the camel will eat up one banana in the way back. So we'll carry the last 1,000 bananas from point A and move forward, and camel will eat up one banana in the way forward. So after point 5, the camel does not need to return to point A again. So to shift 3,000 bananas by 1 kilometer, the camel will eat up 5 bananas. After moving to 200 kilometers, the camel would have eaten up 1,000 bananas and is now left with 2,000 bananas. So now in the part 2, the camel needs to do the following to shift the bananas by 1 kilometer. Move forward with 1,000 bananas, camel will eat up 1 banana in the way forward, leave 998 banana after 1 kilometer and return with 1 banana, camel will eat up this 1 banana in the way back. Pick up the next 1,000 bananas and move forward, and camel will eat up 1 banana in the way forward. After point 3, the camel does not need to return to the starting point of P2. So to shift 2,000 bananas by 1 kilometer, the camel will eat up 3 bananas. After moving to 333 kilometer, the camel would have eaten up 1,000 bananas and is now left with the last 1,000 bananas. Logically, the camel will actually be able to cover 333.33 kilometer. I have ignored the decimal part because it will not make a difference in this example. Hence, the length of part P2 is 333 kilometers. Now for the last part P3, the camel only has to move forward. He has already covered 533 kilometers out of 1,000 kilometers in parts P1 and P2. Now he has to cover only 467 kilometers and he has 1,000 bananas. So camel will eat up 467 bananas on the way forward, and at the destination the camel will be left with only 533 bananas. So 533 bananas is the solution for this particular puzzle. A man has two ropes of varying thickness. Those two ropes are not identical. They aren't the same density, nor the same length, nor the same width. Each rope burns in 60 minutes. He actually wants to measure 45 minutes. How can he measure 45 minutes using only these two ropes? Note, he can't cut the one rope in half because the ropes are non-homogeneous and he can't be sure how long it will burn. He will burn one of the rope at both the ends and the second rope at one end. After half an hour, the first one burns completely, and at this point of time, he will burn the other end of the second rope. So now it will take 15 minutes more to completely burn. So total time is 30 plus 15, which is equal to 45 minutes. You are on your way to visit your grandma, who lives at the end of the valley. It's her anniversary and you want to give her the cakes you have made. Between your house and her house, you have to cross 5 bridges, and as it goes in the land of make-believe, there is a troll under every bridge, and each troll quite rightly insists that you pay a troll toll. Before you can cross the bridge, you have to give them off of the cakes you are carrying. But as they are kind trolls, they each give you back a single cake. How many cakes do you have to leave home with to make sure that you arrive at grandma's with exactly 2 cakes? Solution to this is 2 cakes. The logic is, at each bridge you are required to give off of your cakes and you receive 1 back, which leaves you with 2 cakes after every bridge since you have only 2 cakes. At a party, everyone shook hands with everybody else. There were 66 handshakes. How many people were at the party? Let's say there are n persons. First person shakes hand with everyone else, that is n minus 1 times, that is n minus 1 persons. Second person shakes hand with everyone else, not with first, as it's already done. So the total number of handshakes by the second person will be n minus 2 times. Third person shakes hands with remaining person, that is n minus 3 times. So total handshakes will be n minus 1 plus n minus 2 plus n minus 3 till it becomes 0. So it will become a sum of all natural numbers. Sum of natural numbers can be calculated using the formula n into n plus 1 divided by 2 for n natural numbers. Here in this case, n is n minus 1. So the equation becomes n minus 1 into n minus 1 plus 1 divided by 2. After solving this equation, we will get n is equal to 12 or n is equal to minus 11. So minus 11 is ruled out. So the answer is 12 persons. Sailor needs to bring a wolf, a goat and a cabbage across the river. The boat is tiny and can only carry one passenger at a time. If he leaves the wolf and the goat alone together, the wolf will eat the goat. If he leaves the goat and the cabbage alone together, the goat will eat the cabbage. How can he bring all three safely across the river? The trick to this puzzle is that you can keep wolf and cabbage together. So the solution would be, the sailor will start with the goat. He will go to the other side of the river with the goat. He will keep goat there and will return back and will take cabbage with him on the next turn. When he reaches the other side, he will keep the cabbage there and will take goat back with him. Now you will take wolf and will keep the wolf at the other side of the river along with the cabbage. He will return back and will take goat along with him. This way, they all will cross the river safely. Nine cards are there. You have to arrange them in a 3x3 matrix. Cards are of four colors. They are red, yellow, blue, green. Conditions for arrangement is one red card must be in first row or second row. Two green cards should be in third column. Yellow cards must be in the third corners only. Two blue cards must be in the second row. At least one green card in each row. So this is how we can arrange 9 cards in a 3x3 matrix, where one red card is placed in the first row and two green cards are placed in third column. Yellow cards are placed in the three corners only. Two blue cards are placed in the second row. And finally, at least one green card is placed on each row. In a soap company, a soap is manufactured with 11 parts. For making one soap, you will get one part as scrap. At the end of the day, you have 251 such scraps. From that, how many soaps can be manufactured? Answer to this puzzle is 25. 251 scraps will be used to make 22 soaps with remaining 9 scraps. because 22 into 11, which yields 242, and the remaining will be 9 scraps. Again, to make 22 soaps, it will produce 22 scraps. So 22 plus 9 is equal to 31 scraps, which makes 2 soaps with remaining 9 scraps. Again, the 2 soaps will produce 2 scraps. We have 11 scraps which can be used to make 1 soap with 1 scrap as remaining. Therefore, totally 22 plus 2 plus 1, which is equal to 25 soaps. A big cube painted red on all the sides, it was cut into 27 smaller cubes by 6 straight lines. How many of the smaller cubes painted on all 3 sides, on 2 sides, on 1 side and no face painted? Here the painted cube is cut into 27 equal size smaller cubes. So it has been cut into a 3x3x3 arrangement, and the image that comes to mind is a Rubik's cube. There is one cube in the very center, the middle of 3 in each axis direction. So one cube has no paint. On each of the 6 sides of the cube, there is a central smaller cube that is painted once. Hence, number of one side painted cube is 6. Also, on each of the 6 sides of the cube, there are 4 cubes at the middle of the edges. These are shared with one other side of the cube, or we could just count the 12 edge lines. So 6 into 4 divided by 2, or just 12 smaller cubes are painted on 2 edges. That leaves the 8 corners of the original cube, which are painted on 3 surfaces. So one cube has no paint, and 6 cubes are painted on one side, and 12 cubes are painted on 2 sides, and 8 cubes are painted on 3 sides. So the total 1 plus 6 plus 12 plus 8, which will be equal to 27. Can you make 120 with 5 zeros? This can be achieved using the concept of factorial. The factorial of a non-negative integer is multiplication of all integers smaller than or equal to n. For example, factorial of 6 is 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1, which is 720. And the factorial of 3 is 3 into 2 into 1, which is equal to 6. And also remember, the factorial of 0 is 1. Hence, factorial of 0 plus factorial of 0 plus factorial of 0 plus factorial of 0 plus factorial of 0. So 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1, which is equal to 5. And apply factorial to the sum, which is 5 factorial, which is equal to 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1, which equals to 120. Can you deduce the missing number in the series? Answer to this math puzzle is 122. The logic is, it contains two series. The first series is 5, 13, 29 and 61, and the second series is 10, 26 and 58. The first series is incremented by 8, 16, 32, and the second series is incremented by 16, 32 and 64. The missing number is associated with the second series, hence 58 plus 64 is 122. If one tire of a car suddenly gets stolen and after some time you find the tire without the screws, how will you make your journey complete? open 3 screws, one from each tire, and fix the tire. So in this way, each tire will have 3 screws and journey will be completed. You are given a cake, one of its corner is broken. How will you cut the rest into 2 equal parts? You can cut the rest into 2 equal parts by slicing the cake. There was a cycle race going on. 1/5 of those is in front of a person and 5/6 of those behind him gives the total number of participants. How many people took part in the race? Solution can be achieved using the concept of LCM. According to the problem statement, 1/5 are ahead of a person and 5/6 are behind of person. Let's take LCM of 5 and 6, which is 30. So 1/5 of 30 is equal to 6 persons ahead. 5/6 of 30 is 25 and 25 persons are behind. The sum of the person ahead and behind will give you 31 and including person himself will fetch you 32 persons. So the total number of people took part in the race is 32. There are 5 thieves. Each loot a bakery one after the other such that the first one takes half of the total number of breads plus half of a bread. Similarly, second, third, fourth and fifth also did the same. After the fifth one, number of breads remains are 3. Initially, how many breads were there? Let's solve this problem logically. After 5th loot, number of breads left is equal to 3. So after the 4th loot, number of breads left is equal to 3 plus 0.5 into 2 is equal to 7. After 3rd loot, number of breads left is equal to 7 plus 0.5 into 2, which is equal to 15. After 2nd loot, number of breads left is equal to 15 plus 0.5 into 2, which is equal to 31. After 1st loot, number of breads left is equal to 31 plus 0.5 into 2, which is equal to 63. So before 1st loot, number of breads left is equal to 63 plus 0.5 into 2, which is equal to 127. So there were 127 breads in the bakery. A bag contains X 1 rupee coins and Y 50 paise coins. One coin is taken from the bag and put away. If a coin is now taken at random from the bag, what is the probability that it is a 1 rupee coin? Before checking the solution, it is important to understand how to find the probability. When you calculate probability, you are attempting to figure out the likelihood of a specific event happening. Given a certain number of attempts, probability is the likelihood of one or more events happening divided by the number of possible outcomes. Calculating the probability of multiple events is a matter of breaking the problem down into separate probabilities and the multiplying the separate likelihoods by one another. For example, what is the likelihood of choosing a day that falls on the weekend when randomly picking a day of the week? Choosing a day that falls on the weekend is our event, and the number of outcomes is the total number of days in a week. So the number of events is 2, since 2 days out of the week are weekends, and the number of outcomes is 7, because there are 7 days in a week. So the probability is 2 divided by 7, which is equal to 2 by 7. You could also express this as 0.285 or 28.5%. So let's back to the puzzle. Here, the puzzle says a bag contains X 1 rupee coins and Y 50 paise coins. One coin is taken from the bag and put away. If a coin is now taken at random from the bag, what is the probability that it is a 1 rupee coin? So let's consider the case 1. Let the first coin removed be 1 rupee coin. So 1 rupee coin left is equal to X minus 1. And 50 paise coins left is Y. So probability of getting a 1 rupee coin in the first and the second row is equal to X divided by X plus Y into X minus 1 divided by X minus 1 plus Y. So in the case 2, let the first coin removed be 50 paise coin, 1 rupee coins left is equal to X, 50 paise coins left is equal to Y minus 1. So probability of getting a 50 paise coin in the first and 1 rupee coin in second draw is equal to Y divided by X plus Y into X divided by X plus Y minus 1. So total probability is equal to sum of these two, which is equal to X divided by X plus Y after simplification. Hence, the probability that it is a 1 rupee coin is X divided by X plus Y. So in the given series, which number is strong in the series? Let's understand the logic behind the series. Here the logic is, subtract the given number with the incremental of natural numbers and multiply by the multiples of 2. Take the outcome and again perform the same operation. So here in this example, here the first number is 7. Subtract the number from 1 and multiply with 2, which results in 12. Now subtract 12 from 2 and multiply with 4, which results in 40, and repeat the same for the other numbers as well. As we can see here, fifth number in the sequence is wrong and the correct number should be 1744. So that's all for this video. Hope these puzzles are going to help you in your interview. Like the video if it found useful for you, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching. Let's meet in the next video. Thank you.